According to a new national survey by the American Red Cross, many people overestimate their ability to react to a home fire. And as a result, they kind of miss those critical life-saving steps that could keep their loved ones safe. In fact, you guys, 40% of people believe they are more likely to win the lottery or get struck by lightning than to experience a home fire, when home fires are actually the most common disaster people face in this country. So American Red Cross President and CEO Gail McGovern is here to kind of help us be prepared better than we already are. Gail, thank you so much for being with us.
It is my pleasure to be on the show, Tina. Thanks for having me.
Well, now I mentioned some of the stuff that was coming out of the survey, already big shocker. What were some of the other things that came out of the survey?
Well, first of all, people not only think it's unlikely for them to experience a home fire, but they also admit to the fact that they might have left the stove on or the oven on, or they weren't paying attention to a space heater. And so they realize that they're doing things that could cause a home fire. They don't think one's gonna happen, and what's worse, they're not prepared for one. They don't have a plan to evacuate. Lots of people don't have working smoke alarms. And as you said, this is the most common disaster. We respond to 64,000 disasters on average every single year, and the vast majority of them are home fires, and tragically, 7 people die every day from home fires. It's the worst disaster yet.
Well, and that's why the American Red Cross is coming with an initiative to kind of get that information out. Tell me about that.
So, first of all, starting in October of 2014, we started installing free smoke alarms because we just had the need to do something, because we're seeing this on the ground every single day. And I am really proud of the fact that since that time, we have installed 1.1 million smoke alarms throughout the United States. And the best number of all is that 416 lives have been saved so far. So what we're up to right now is we're putting a big blitz. We're going to have 16 concentrated days where we are going to attempt to install 100,000 smoke alarms in 100 different cities across the country. And in order to do that, we're galvanizing 28,000 volunteers to help us out.
And so how, if somebody's watching us right now, Gail, how do they get involved?
So they can go on to soundthealarm.org, that's our website. They can see where we're gonna be and how they can come out into the community and install smoke alarms. If they don't have the time to volunteer, they can always give a financial donation to help us pay for these free smoke alarms. And these campaigns are a great way for communities to come together. And we literally go door by door by door. We have step ladders and drills and lots of free smoke alarms, and we will install them right there on the spot. And we also will sit down with families and make sure they know how to get out of their homes in 2 minutes or less, because that's all the time you have to evacuate. And we make sure they have a good plan, that they check their alarms, and that they are taking the right steps to avoid death and injury.
These are definite steps that we can do, like you said, to save those lives. Gail, thank you so much for this information today.
Thank you for having me on the show, Tina. I appreciate it.
Don't go anywhere. The Morning Blend, we'll be right back.